you have big goals for 2022. Same here. But you just need to get things tidied up so you can totally crush them. It's time to get your business organized now so you can hit the ground running after the holidays. Hey guys, Christy here from DeSilva Life, and I'm going to teach you some tips today on how to get your business organized for the new year. So, how do you do that? I think it's important to review the systems that you already have in place, if any. And then you can decide which systems you need to create and put in place so you can hit the ground running. So let's talk about one of the first systems that is small but mighty, your email inbox. Did you know that you can systematize your email inbox? Absolutely. When it comes to systems, I'm not just talking about fancy softwares and programs. I'm talking about processes. Step by step, what happens when you open up your email inbox every morning? Is it a total source of stress and overwhelm? Do you currently have a process of how you decide what is urgent, what can be responded to later, and how to filter those things and label them and put them away? Here are a few tips you can do to really start getting on top of your inbox. Go ahead and start creating labels for the different types of categories you have in your business. This will give you some organization in what you know you need to take care of in different areas. But you can also have labels that are things like need to respond, urgent, read later. So you also know the priority of these emails. And yes, you can have two or more labels on something. So it can live in clients and also needs a response. There are so many different tips I can teach you on how to keep your inbox organized and reach inbox zero, but I actually have a whole free training on that exact thing. So if you're interested in that, I will drop the link in the description below for you to download and watch that training today. And now let's talk about client or customer management. Let's talk about how your customer management went last year. Starting with onboarding. While you're onboarding your clients, is the process smooth? Are you constantly asking for one more thing? Are they asking a million questions and you're eventually gonna get to them, but you haven't established that from the beginning? Did they compliment your process? Or do you feel like it was taking weeks to actually get started and waiting for the contracts, invoices, everything to be paid and squared away before your project actually began? If it was the last one, don't feel bad. Tons of business owners feel this way. But this is why I want to talk to you about setting up a CRM in your business for 2022. CRM stands for Customer Relationship Management Tool, and it can do amazing things. It can track leads, schedule calls, have a whole bunch of amazing templates to quickly upload and send to clients, and have automations where you're sending emails, questionnaires, brochures to your clients automatically. Our favorite CRM is HoneyBook, and we use it to manage all of our client operations when it comes to onboarding and sending all of the details, check-ins, everything that we need for our client projects. To set yourself up for success in 2022, you can use HoneyBook to track leads after they filled out your contact form or you grabbed a discovery call, to create portals for each new client, to template out your contracts, invoices, proposals, emails, and easily send them to your clients in less than 2 minutes, or automatically. To create workflows and send those emails, questionnaires, brochures automatically and be able to step away from your business knowing things are running behind the scenes. And to track the progress and communication of your client's project. Before you know it, you'll be able to track where every single lead or client stands, onboard your clients super smoothly, and manage all communication without feeling like you're constantly living out of your email inbox or your notebook. If you want 50% off your first year of HoneyBook and you're ready to dive in and set it up, you can use the link in the description below. Okay, now let's talk project management. Do you know what you're working on at any given time? Or are you constantly responding to late projects and tasks trying to catch up on your work? Or are you rushing into things and trying to just get as much done as possible in the beginning of the project when it's not necessarily priority? If this is you, you seriously need a project management tool. Trust me. Project management, even though it sounds fancy, it's pretty simple. It's just the way you track and manage all the projects and tasks within your business. It makes sure that you're keeping track of all of the moving parts and nitty-gritty tasks within your business, and also makes it so easy to be able to delegate things out to your team. My favorite project management tool is ClickUp, and it can do so many incredible things. We have a variety of videos on our channel of different tutorials for ClickUp and HoneyBook systems, all the things. So make sure you subscribe to our channel if you want to learn all about them. The beautiful thing about ClickUp is that you can set all of the standard tasks that you have to do within a project, set start and due dates for them, who's assigned to it, and then you can template out the entire thing. So the next time you get that same project, it's just a click of a button away to seeing the entire project unfold before your eyes. You can also create beautiful dashboards within ClickUp to track internal and external information and really organize everything together. It's not just when it comes to your projects. You can also track financial metrics, time tracking and team management, and so many other things. A whole video on ClickUp dashboards, so I'll drop the link in the description below if you want to check that out as well. A project management tool can be the place where you go to see what you have to do on any given day, week, or month, track the progress on any of your projects or tasks, and really get a holistic overview of how you run your business. It's pretty rad if you ask me. So if you want to learn more about ClickUp, but you're a little overwhelmed diving in, I have a free ClickUp 101 guide for you that you can download today. And lastly, let's talk about calendar management. So we have covered inbox management, we've covered systems, and then let's bring it all together talking about your calendar. One of my favorite productivity tips and tools is time blocking. I set my calendar with intention. On a weekly level, I time block it in Google Calendar to set themes for each day. Whether I'm working on admin and having calls with my team, whether I'm just working on DaSilva Life stuff, having a CEO day and not letting anything else distract me, or whether I am neck deep in client projects. I make sure I know what I'm working on any given day so I can stay focused on that thing. As the CEO of your business, you are busy. So much going on any given day, and it can be incredibly hard to stay focused on what's in front of you. So that's why I really recommend organizing your calendar and utilizing time blocking. This also includes setting boundaries around your time. So I use my scheduler within my CRM, HoneyBook, to be able to block off calls only on the days that I want to have them during the week. I also block off how many calls I want to take on any given day, so I'm not overwhelmed with the amount and burnt out at the end. You can also get scheduling tools like Calendly or Acuity to do the same thing. But if you're using a CRM, I highly recommend choosing one with a scheduling tool so you can have it all in one. You can also set things like CEO days to make sure you're working on your business, not just in it. You're prioritizing that business growth and development that you so desire. Then you also want to set those days where you're working on your client work or taking those calls. Deciding these ahead of time and sticking to your boundaries is so key. If you want to learn how I do my time tracking on a weekly and daily basis, check out the time blocking bundle in the description below. It's going to teach you how to actually set your time block in your Google Calendar as well as your ClickUp. And we also have so many other amazing free resources for you, whether it's the videos on the DaSilva Life channel or our freebies on our website. So make sure to check those out, download them, and start getting your systems in place so you can totally crush it in 2022. If you have any other questions about systems, organization, setting your goals, make sure to drop them in the comments below. And thanks for watching.